It's yes, we can see
it. We can see it.
We can see it now. Yes.
This is what the example that you have given to us, right? When you come to the 92, the calculate quartiles for 92, 43, 162, 144, and first what I have done is I arranged from minimum to max.
Okay.
Minimum to max, and for quartile one, I have taken the mean of the 35 plus 43 divided by 2.
Okay.
And the same thing I have done for Q3 also.
Mm-hmm.
I have taken the rest of the six numbers, and in 128 and 129, I have taken a mean.
Okay.
Q2 is nothing but, as you told, the median average between minimum to maximum, whatever the numbers are, is Q2.
Mm-hmm.
And this IQR quartile also I have calculated. That is nothing but Q3 minus Q1 is equal to interquartile.
Okay. Okay.
Whether this is correct or not.
Okay. So in this example, which you have, which you are sharing, in this example, I think the formula that you've used for calculating Q1 and Q3, can you just click on the cell E where you mentioned 30? Okay. So here, what you have done is you have arranged the data into minimum to maximum in an ascending order, wherein you have taken the average of the third and the fourth value. Okay. Rather than that, if you properly use a formula which we have in quartile, which is quartile, and you select the entire range, just try this one. Put your cursor on cell number F3 or F5.
Yeah.
Just next to 39 in F. Yeah.
Now here.
Yes. Yes. So now use the formula quartile is equal to. Use it is equal to first.
Sorry. Yeah.
Oh, not an issue.
Okay.
Yeah. Press tab, or maybe you can click on this one. Yes. Select the entire range from 5 to 162 towards the end. Towards in the, yeah. Give a comma.
Comma.
One.
You should remove the bracket.
Yeah, I think you've used a bracket, so that is not required. Just try once again, not an issue.
Yeah. Is it okay now?
Yes, yeah, now put a bracket, closing bracket.
Close the bracket. Hit enter. Yes. So this is a quartile one that we have.
And why 39? Then,
yeah. Similarly, if you want to calculate quartile 2, quartile 3, quartile 4, the only thing you have to do is just replace the entire formula with comma 2, comma 3, comma 4 for quartile 2, quartile 3, quartile 4 respectively.
What is the formula? Why am I thinking, is it not the formula of what I have done? It is an Excel, okay, agreed. But what is the manual formula for this?
So there are 12 observations for this number. Okay. So now we are saying that we have to take the four groups out of it. Okay. So if the number would have been a multiple of four, it would have been very easy for us to calculate. And when we'll be working on big data, it is not very easy to calculate these numbers. So therefore, the prime focus is on to calculate it using an Excel. And once we have the access to Minitab, we would be able to use that as well. So that's the reason we focus and rely on this formula, which would help you to calculate the positional value, which is at first 25%, the next 25%, the next 25%, and the last quartile. So that gave you, so if you want to do it, probably you can just replicate comma 1, comma 2, comma 3, and comma 4, and you'll be able to calculate the same.
Okay. That's this formula type, I don't have an idea, but why physically formula we are not able to get, that is only the worry, is it?
So since we would always be working on a big data, we would not have the observations like this ever. This is to make you aware. The prime focus of quartile is to make you aware that which quartile has major variance. Okay.
See, if you see, Q2 is coming rightly. See, 113.5, 113.5.
Yeah.
But why Q1 is coming 39, here is 41, and here 128.5, and here is 128.25.
Right. So that's what I'm saying. In this particular observation, we have, in this particular data set, we have 12 observations, okay? From 5 till 162. The logic that you applied for calculating quartile in your existing formula is, you have taken the third and the fourth value and took the sum out of it, okay? However, while calculating quartile, there is not a fixed rule that we have to take the third and the fourth one, okay?
Okay.
Yeah. Likewise, when we go for a median, then we know that the average, the middle value is the observation. However, this divides the data into four, okay? Since we don't have exact 16 observations, that's the reason we use a formula, and this formula automatically calculates the difference between first, second, and third and fourth quartiles. So that's how you'll be able to do it. There is a, likewise, I said last time as well, there is a graphical tool which is called Boxplot, which would help us to look at those things in a graphical manner. And then we'll be able to calculate Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4 there only. And you'll be able to highlight which particular bucket has a major variance. And there you'll be able to calculate the IQR as well. So instead of using the third and the fourth value and take the average out of it, it is always recommended to use a formula which would give you an exact positional number where you would require to focus. Okay. So here in this particular formula, you would have seen the majority of the variance lies in the Q2. Okay. And because the moment the number exceeded, there is not major variance in Q3 and Q4. The majority of the variance lies there in Q2. So there would always be an opportunity to look at that, what happens in that particular part. So that's the purpose of calculating quartiles.
You mean to say minimum data should be around 16 for calculating physics?
Yeah, so what I'm saying is that if we have 16 data, it is not a minimum or a maximum, because when we do the analysis, we would have a big data always. But just for an example perspective, that's how we always tell that if we have the exact multiple of 4, probably if you use a multiple of 4, probably 8, okay, then you would have 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. Okay, so you can try that as well, and then you would see that the result would be same.
That